Hello students, hope all of you are fine at your places. Today we will continue our chapter 5, the fundamental unit of life. In earlier class we have read about cell, its components. In components we have read about plasma membrane, cell membrane, nucleus, and today we will read about cytoplasm and cell organelles. Now if we talk about cytoplasm, it is a jelly-like substance which is present inside the cell, inside the plasma membrane. It contains many specialized cell organelles, and each cell organelle perform its specific function. Now we talk about significance of membrane. We have one example of virus. Viruses, they are connecting link between living and non-living. Whenever virus is outside the living organism, it is considered as, can anybody tell, it is considered as non-living. When it enters the living organism body, it is considered as living organism. It is because of membrane only. Now we will talk about cell organelles. Now cell organelles, in this chapter we will read about endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, lysosome, mitochondria and blastids. These cell organelles we will read in detail. Firstly we will talk about endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum is also known as, the abbreviation is ER. They are large network of sheets and long tubules, sac-like structure is also there. Now what are the functions of ER? It provides surface for activities, biochemical activities. Cytoplasm ke andar jitni bhi biochemical activities hoti hain, usko kaun surface deta hai? It is provided by ER. And it also serves as a channel for transport of material from one place to another place inside the cell. If we talk about types of ER, two types are there. RER and SER. RER is known as rough endoplasmic reticulum and SER is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. If we see under the microscope, rough endoplasmic reticulum, it look rough because of the presence of ribosomes, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum, under the microscope it looks smooth because there is no ribosomes present. One term is membrane biogenesis. In membrane biogenesis, endoplasmic reticulum plays an important role, as endoplasmic reticulum synthesizes both proteins and lipids, which is required for the formation of membrane. That's why the term is known as membrane biogenesis. Now see the structure of rough endoplasmic reticulum under the microscope, and it looks like this. Smooth endoplasmic reticulums look like this. Now we talk about the functions of endoplasmic reticulums. Rough endoplasmic reticulum, it help in protein synthesis, as it contain ribosomes, and some proteins function as hormones and some as enzymes. Second one is SER, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. It help in the synthesis of lipids and play crucial role in detoxifying many poisons and drugs which is present in the liver of vertebrates. Vertebrates are group of animals. In their liver, if poisons or toxins are there, to SER, what it do? It detoxify. Detoxify matlab uske asar ko kam kar deta hai. Got it? Now second one is Golgi apparatus. It is firstly described by Camillo Golgi. They are membrane bound flattened sac-like structures, tube-like structures or sac-like structures. They are arranged parallel to each other and known as cisterns. Now if we talk about function, first function is storage, modification and packaging. Second is simple, it converts, Golgi apparatus converts simple sugar into complex sugars, and Golgi apparatus is also help in the formation of lysosomes. Now these three are the functions of Golgi apparatus. If in exam it is asked, write three function of Golgi apparatus. If you write storage, modification, packaging, you will get only 1 marks because it is the first function. Other two functions you have to write for 3 marks. Got it? Then we are having lysosomes. Lysosomes are also known as suicidal bags, scavengers of the cell. They are membrane bound sacs and they contain digestive enzymes. These digestive enzymes are very, very powerful enzymes which digest the worn out cell and foreign particles which comes into our body. They clean the waste which is present in the cell. That's why it help in the waste disposal. They break down complex molecules into simple substances. They are known as suicide bags. Why? They are known as suicide bags because when there is some malfunctioning in the cell or metabolic activity is not proper in the cell, so what they do, the lysosome, what they do, the vesicles in which digestive enzymes are present, they break out, they burst up and they engulf their own cell, they eat up their own cell. That's why they are known as suicide bags. Next is mitochondria. Mitochondria is also known as powerhouse of the cell. Now mitochondria have two layers. This is the first one and this is the second one. The first one is known as outer membrane. It is the porous one which help in the exchange of material, and the inner one, it is a deeply folded. It is deeply folded. Why it is deeply folded? Can anybody tell? It is deeply folded because it provides large surface area for oxidation of food. When oxidation of food is there, what is produced? It releases energy in the form of ATP, adenosine triphosphate, adenosine triphosphate, and ATP is also known as energy currency. The energy requirement of our body is satisfied, fulfilled by mitochondria in the form of ATP. It produces ATP. Mitochondria is known as strange organelle because it have their own DNA and ribosomes for the production of proteins. It is double membraned, then it has their own DNA and they have own ribosomes for the protein production. That's why it is known as strange organelle. Next topic is plastids. We talk about plastids. Plastids are present in plant cell only. In animal cell, plastids are not present. And plastids are of two type, chromoplast and leucoplast. In other reference books, you will find that three types are given, but please don't stick to that. Stick to NCERT book, according to which plastids are of two type, chromoplast and leucoplast. I'm again repeating, according to NCERT, plastids are of two type, chromoplast and leucoplast. Chromoplast is a colored plastid and leucoplast is the white or colorless plastids. Now, what is the function of chromoplast? Chromoplast give color to various part of chloroplast. It gives color to various part of chloroplast. Sorry, various parts of plant. And chloroplast is a type of chromoplast. Chloroplast is a type of chromoplast which contain green pigment which is known as chlorophyll, and it is very helpful in the presence of what? In the process of photosynthesis. Yes. And leucoplast, they are colorless or white plastid. And what is the function? They store starch, oil and proteins. Now they also have, plastids also have DNA and ribosomes like mitochondria. They are double membraned, they have DNA, they have ribosomes, they can make their own protein like mitochondria. If we talk about structure, this is stroma, this cavity space is stroma, and grana is there. These are granas and the whole, it is known as thylakoid. And here chloroplast is there which help in the process of photosynthesis. So this is all about plastids. Now we will talk about vacuoles. Vacuoles, you have heard about vacuoles? Yes, vacuoles are storage sac. They are sac-like structures which help in storage. In animals, vacuoles are very, very small. In plants, vacuoles are large, up to 50 to 90% of cell volume in plant is occupied by vacuoles. In plant, it provides turgidity and rigidity to the cell. It stores amino acids, sugar, proteins, and some other organic acids. Now we talk about vacuoles in plants and animals. In animals, vacuoles are very, very small, but in plants, large vacuole is present. In animals, if vacuoles are present, they may be 2, 3, or 4 in number. But in plants, vacuoles, only single vacuole is there. In animals, vacuoles are present in the cytoplasm. They may be scattered anywhere in the cytoplasm. But in plants, they cover the center part of the plant cell. So these are the difference between plant cell and animal cell with respect to vacuoles. They can be asked in exam for 3 marks. So learn it carefully. I am again repeating it. I have not written here, but I am repeating. In animal cell, small vacuoles are there. In plant cell, large vacuoles are there. In animal cell, if vacuoles are present, they may be 2, 3, or 4, 5 in number. But in plant cell, only a large vacuole is present. In plant cell, vacuole is scattered in the cytoplasm. But in animal cells, they are scattered in the cytoplasm. In plant cells, vacuoles, what they do? They occupy the center position of the cell. Our next topic is cell division. What do you mean by cell division? When one cell divided into two cells for the growth, that is known as cell division. Now, cell division is of two types, mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis and meiosis. Is it clear? Now, mitosis is a cell division which is for growth of the organism. क्या होता है? एक सेल से दो बन गए, फिर आगे एक सेल से फिर दो बने, फिर एक सेल से फिर दो बने, तो इट इज़ फॉर ग्रोथ. ईच मदर सेल डिवाइड्स इंटू टू डॉटर सेल. एक सेल से कितने सेल बनेंगे? दो बने. फिर उनमें से एक सेल में से फिर कितने बनेंगे? दो बनेंगे. तो ये जो प्रोसेस है वो रिपीट होता रहता है. तो जिस उसकी वजह से क्या होता है, नंबर ऑफ सेल इंक्रीजेस. व्हेन नंबर ऑफ सेल इंक्रीज, व्हाट विल हैपन? What will happen if number of cell increase? Yes, growth is there. The organism ka size hai, body size hai, it will increase. Now, after the division, after the mitosis, the number of chromosome remains same in the daughter cells. जितने मदर सेल के पास क्रोमोसोम्स थे, उतने ही क्रोमोसोम्स किसके पास होते हैं? डॉटर सेल के पास होते हैं. Is it clear? And it help in growth and repair. जो growth हो रही है उसमें भी help करता है, और worn out cell है या कुछ भी है तो उसको भी repair करता है. कौन? Mitosis, cell division. Next one is meiosis. Meiosis, it for gamete formation. It help in reproduction. तो जो gametes बनते हैं वो किससे बनते हैं? With the help of meiosis, cell division. It produces 4 न्यू सेल्स. एक सेल से कितने सेल बनते हैं? 4 सेल्स बनते हैं. हाफ नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स आर एज ऑफ मदर सेल्स. जितने मदर सेल्स के पास क्रोमोसोम है उसका क्या हो जाता है? हाफ हो जाता है. कैन यू थिंक व्हाई इट इज़ हाफ? गेमीट्स के अंदर हमेशा जो पेरेंट सेल है उससे हाफ क्रोमोसोम्स होते हैं. क्यों? आई विल टेल यू द रीज़न. इफ यू सी स्पर्म एंड एग, स्पर्म के अंदर सपोज वी विल टॉक अबाउट ह्यूमन बींग्स. इन ह्यूमन बींग्स 23 पेयर्स ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स आर देयर. टोटल नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम आर 46. 23 पेयर्स. तो 23 पेयर्स के अंदर से 23 क्रोमोसोम्स जो हैं वो आते हैं फ्रॉम द स्पर्म. एंड 23 क्रोमोसोम्स हैं वो कहाँ से मिलते हैं? वो मिलते हैं ओवम या एग से. व्हेन दे फ्यूज द क्रोमोसोम्स नंबर बिकम 46. ठीक है जी. दैट्स मीन 23 पेयर्स. दैट्स वाई देर इज़ अ हाफ नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स. तो जो न्यू इंडिविजुअल बन रहा है थ्रू द गिमीट्स, उसके पास कितने क्रोमोसोम्स आएंगे? 46 क्रोमोसोम्स और 23 पेयर्स. नाउ द सेल डिवीजन, माइटोसिस सेल डिवीजन, इट इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज इक्वेशन सेल डिवीजन. एंड हेयर इट इज़ नोन एज रिडक्शनल सेल डिवीजन. रिडक्शनल क्यों? क्योंकि क्रोमोसोम्स जो हैं वो इसमें रिड्यूस हो जाते हैं. और यहाँ इक्वेशनल क्यों? क्योंकि सेम रहते हैं. तो ये हो गया आपका सेल डिवीजन. सो इन दिस चैप्टर टुडे वी हैव रेड अबाउट साइटोप्लाज्म, देन वी हैव रेड अबाउट सेल ऑर्गेनेल्स. कौन कौन से सेल ऑर्गेनेल्स वी हैव रेड अबाउट एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम, देन वी हैव रेड अबाउट लाइजोसोम्स, गोल्की अपरेटस, प्लास्टिड्स, माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया, लाइजोसोम्स. ठीक है जी, वी हैव रेड ऑल अबाउट दीज vacuoles and we have read about cell division. It's of two type, mitosis and meiosis. Just keep in mind mitosis is for growth and meiosis is for gametes formation. So this is all for today's lecture. Stay home, stay safe.